The chapter admission of a partner is over. We discussed two adjustment methods, method number one and two. With that, chapter admission is over. We'll continue this chapter, that is chapter two of volume one. This is volume one itself. Fundamentals of partnership. Already we discussed past adjustments. Then we discussed that rectification part. All those portions we discussed. We had to discuss one more topic, that is guarantee of profit. That time I had told you that we'll be learning this portion only after we finish the next chapter. That means admission. So admission chapter is over now. Now we'll discuss this topic, guarantee of profit. This can be discussed along with the topic profit and loss appropriation that we learned already. Guarantee of profit. The meaning is, when a new partner is admitted into your firm, a minimum profit will be guaranteed to the partner. Example, suppose C is admitted to the firm, A and B are the old partners, and it is said that C would be given a minimum profit of rupees 30,000. And this minimum profit must be given even if it is a loss for the firm. So that is the guaranteed profit which you have to give, and it will be sometimes given by all remaining partners. That means by both A and B. Then sometimes it will be given only by one of the partners, either A or B. That is the decision of the firm. So here C is to be given 30,000, that is the minimum guaranteed profit. But when you calculated the profit, suppose you divided the profit of that particular year between A, B and C, and C got an amount of, I mean C's share is 25,000. As per the ratio, when you divided that year's profit, C to be given 25,000. But are we going to give C only 25,000? No. We have to give C the agreed profit always. The minimum profit must be given to C. Whichever is higher, that you have to pay. That's the easiest way. Whichever is higher, that you have to pay C. So now, as per the ratio, you will be giving only 25. Since we have guaranteed 30, we have to pay 5 more. So there is a deficiency of 5,000 rupees, and how will you take this deficiency, or who will pay this deficiency? It would be done either by A and B together, or either by A or B. Understood? Sometimes it will be done by both A and B. Sometimes it will be done either by A or by B. That is their decision. So in this question, in these type of questions, the deficiency is to be borne by all remaining partners or by one of the partners. So whichever is higher, that you have to pay. Suppose when you computed the ratio, you got C's profit as 50. Are you going to give him 30 only? No. Whichever is higher, you have to pay. So now you have to pay him an amount of 50,000. Minimum profit is 30. Minimum that you have to ensure can be more than that. Understood? If it is 25 only as per the ratio, you must give 30. So whichever is higher, we will pay him. So we'll work out problems based on this guarantee of profit, and it will be included in the topic P&L appropriation. We'll first work out illustration number 49. Illustration 49. A, B and C are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 4:2:1. It is provided that C's share in profit would not be less than. So that is the minimum guaranteed profit. Profit for the year ended was 1,57,500. We have to do P&L appropriation account. So draw the format, profit and loss appropriation account for the year ended. The date is 31st March 2020. Now we'll draw the format, particulars amount, give the column headings also. Here we are starting with the net profit. So you write on the credit side, by net profit. Just see the format of P&L appropriation by net profit. The amount is 1,57,500. Do we have any items like salary, capital, commission? No. So nothing to be written on the debit side. We can just transfer this profit, distribute this profit among partners. Yes, when you distribute it among partners, that means you have to give to C also. So now we'll distribute this to A's capital. Then A, B and C, distribute it among all three. And if it is a question with guaranteed profit, this is a question which includes P&L appropriation and there is guarantee of profit also. So if it is a question like this, you leave one line when you write the capital balances. Okay, leave one line and write, I'll tell you what is the reason. So 2C is capital. We are just going to divide that balancing figure. That's the balancing figure here is 1,57,500. That we'll divide between A, B, C. In which ratio? In their new ratio, you have to divide. Since we are giving a portion to C also, we have to take the new ratio. And here we have only one ratio, that is 4:2, 2:1. It's a ratio between A, B and C. So 1,57,500, you divide in 4:2, 2:1. Then A will be getting, you must show the calculation there. Now I'll write the amounts. A will be getting 90,000. That is 1,57,500 into 4/7. And that 90,000 you write in the inner column. Don't go and write in the outer column directly. Write in the inner column. Then B's capital, it is 45. Then the next person, 22,500. All these you have to compute. Divide in the new ratio. 4:2, 2:1. Now we'll read that guarantee profit. Guarantee of profit. We have to give C an amount of 37,500. So that is the guaranteed profit. C, as per the ratio, he will get only 22,500. But we have to give him how much? 37,500, the minimum agreed profit. Whichever is higher, that you have to pay. So this 37,500 must come in your outer column. So what is the deficiency? The deficiency means the difference between these two. The difference will be 15,000. The difference is 15,000 and that deficiency, 37,500 minus 22,500, that deficiency of 15,000, who will meet? Read the question. Is it mentioned who is going to bear the deficiency? No. If nothing is mentioned, who will bear? A and B together will bear. If nothing is mentioned, in which ratio they will bear? We have only one ratio given there, and the ratio between A and B you have to take. Understood? A and B together they will pay to C. And the ratio between A and B, what is the ratio? It is given 4:2, 2:1. So A and B's ratio will be 4:2. Just cut C's share, you will get A and B's share. So 4:2 is the ratio between A and B, and this deficiency of 15,000 we will take from A and B in this particular ratio 4:2. So from A, how much you will be taking? The calculation will be, I will show the calculation here. From A, the deficiency to be taken is 15,000. That's the difference between these two figures into 4/6. 4/6 means 4:2 is the ratio. From B, he will be taking 15,000 into 2/6. So that is the deficiency being taken from A and B. So what you have to write is, so the amounts will be like 10,000 and 5,000. You have to write here, we have left one line in between. There you must write less C's share of deficiency, because A can't be given entire 90. A has to pay something to C. That is the deficiency which you calculated, 10,000. A should give 10,000, and from B also we will less something. That is again less C's share of deficiency. How much B is giving? B is giving 5, right? When you divide it, the 15,000 in 4:2 ratio, you will get like this. So in outer columns you can show the balance. And now with C is capital, you have to add deficiency, recovered from A and B, will write separately. From A, how much did we recover? From A, we recovered 10. So that figures will add here. That 15,000 will add and show here. Then again add deficiency, recovered from B. That is 5,000. So altogether we'll pay him 37,500. That is the minimum guaranteed profit. So this is how you have to include guarantee of profit in P&L appropriation. When you divide the amounts, leave one line and write the division. I mean, those figures you must write in the inner column, then see the deficiency, and that deficiency we have to share between the, I mean, it will be shared by the old partners if nothing is mentioned in their old ratio. So 4:2 is the old ratio between A and B. We divided in that particular ratio. Now you can close, since we don't have any items like salary, commission and all. The account is over. Next, we'll work out illustration number 51. Illustration 51, that question was asked in board exam, that is 2018 board exam. They have written within brackets 2018 board exam. This question was asked for 8 marks question. Usually from this portion, this P&L appropriation and guarantee of profit, usually what they ask is only for 4 marks. Last year for board exam, they asked only for 4 marks. But 2018 board exam, they had asked this question, the same question they had asked for 8 marks question. Only after that they included it in your textbook, okay. They didn't get this question before. Okay, so we'll start this. You have to prepare P&L appropriation. We'll just go through the question, see the information given. Three partners, Moli, Bola, Raj, their ratio is given 3:3:4. Then partnership deed provided the following: interest on capital, interest on drawing. So many items are there other than your net profit. Interest on partner's loan. You remember this item? Interest on partner's loan is a charge against profit. There is a difference between appropriation and charge against profit. What is charge against profit? It must be paid even if the firm is incurring loss. And are we going to show interest on loan here in P&L appropriation? No. It should be shown in the previous account, that is P&L account. Then Molly was allowed an annual salary of 4,000. Bola was allowed a commission. Then Raj is to be guaranteed a profit. See, we have guarantee of profit here. Then fixed capitals are given. That means we will have to write it as current accounts. Don't write capital accounts. We have to write current accounts. Fixed capitals of three partners are given. Bola extended a loan of 1 lakh to the firm. The net profit before interest on Bola's loan is 3,06,000. Can we start the question with 3,06,000? No, because that 3,06,000 includes interest. And interest on loan is something that we had to take in P&L, which we forgot to take. So how will you start your P&L appropriation? You must write by net profit. How much will you write? You can write only the balance. I mean, less interest you have to take. Deduct interest and take the net profit. Then what else is given? Prepare P&L appropriation and current accounts. They have asked you to do one more account, that is partner's current account. Only if they ask you to prepare like this, you need to prepare, or else stop your question with P&L appropriation. Assuming that, there is one more sentence, read each and every word. Bola withdrew 5,000 at the end of each month. Moli withdrew 10,000 at the end of each quarter. And Raj at the end of half year. So how they are withdrawing, and you know that interest on drawings, whenever you compute, you must consider the time period. Here they have given when they are withdrawing, each of these three partners, when they are withdrawing amounts. So we have to consider that average period method. You remember, when it is unequal amount withdrawn at, sorry, equal amounts withdrawn at regular intervals, you have to consider the average period method. So that formula also we'll have to apply here. So this is a comprehensive question which includes almost all topics in this chapter. Yes, so P&L appropriation will start. For the year ended March 31st, 2017. Is it given 2017? Yes. Yes. It was given in 2018 present paper. 2017. We'll start with by net profit. That's taken from P&L. Net profit given here is 3,06,000. That should come in the inner column because we have something to deduct. What should we deduct? The interest that you forgot to take it in P&L. So now we have to deduct and take the net profit. And interest on Bola's loan. Bola's loan amount is given as 1 lakh and the interest rate is 6%. So 1 lakh into 6/100. So interest will be 6,000 and the net profit you can start now with 3 lakhs. Don't start with 3,06,000. Entire question will go wrong. Then what else we have? We have interest on capitals, and where you will write interest on capitals? Just revise your P&L appropriation format. Interest on capital will come on the debit side. Interest on capitals, and in a column you must write what are their names? Moli, Bola, Raj. Moli's current account you must write, because it is fixed capital method. Moli, Bola, Raj. Moli's current account, then Bola, no? Yes, Bola's current account and Raj's current account. Amount, how will you get? On capital amounts, you have to compute. Capital amounts given here, 5 lakhs, 8 lakhs, 4 lakhs. So Moli's calculation will be 5 lakhs into what is the rate of interest? That is 5%. Then here the next person will be 8 lakhs into 5%. So just compute on their capital balances. So it will be 25,000. If you want, you directly write in the outer column so that it will be easier. Again, no need to compute. Write in the outer column. 25,000, 40,000. What about the third person? 4 lakhs into 5%, that is 20,000. You can directly write in the outer column, or else you will have to total it and then write it again. So don't waste your time. To interest on capital, then see whether you have any salary. Yes, salary to be given, but only to Mola. Not Mola, sorry, Moli. The name is Moli. Yes. Salary, to salary, and you write their name here. We are giving only to Moli. So to Moli's current account, you must mention. And how much you are giving? 4,000 annually. If it was 4,000 per month, what you will do? You must do into 12. Then interest on drawings. Will you write interest on drawings on the debit side? No. That increases your profit, should come on the credit side. So by interest on drawings. Drawings need not be taken here. By interest on drawings, and you have to do calculation. That working note you have to show below this account. So we'll stop this account now, leave space for completing. We'll start the working note. And that calculation is also familiar to you. Average period method. You remember the formula? Months left after first withdrawal plus months left after last drawings divided by 2. That is how you are getting average period. So we will compute interest on drawings. The first one, Moli. And what is the formula for computing interest on drawings? The first one I'll write. We have discussed already in the beginning of the chapter. Total drawings into rate by 100 into average period by 12. Always remember, whenever you compute interest on drawings, consider the time period. So here we have to apply this particular formula, average period method. Total drawings for Moli. Moli withdrew 10,000 at the end of each quarter. And how many quarters are there in 1 year? There would be 4 quarters. So 10,000 into 4, that is the total drawings. Don't write 10,000 simply. Rate. What is the rate of interest? Is 12%. into average period by 12. What is the average period when withdrawal take place at the end of each quarter? The calculation will be end of each quarter means one quarter means 3 months. So after first quarter, you have a period of 9 months. After last quarter, it will be zero. So this is the average period, 9 plus 0 by 2. So that is 4.5 by 12. You can write it as 4.5 by 12. You do the calculation and get the answer. Since we discussed already, I'm not doing it again. But you have to do average period is equal to months left after first drawings. You have to write all those. Then you will get the answer as 4.5 by 12. Yes, so 4.5 months and here it is 1800. The drawings figure will be 1800. Then the second partner, Bola. For Bola, what is the total drawings? He is withdrawing. Bola withdrew 5000 at the end of each month. So 5000 into 12. That is the total drawings. Into rate is 12%. And average period, how will you take? Months left after first drawings. How many months are there after first withdrawal? There will be 11 months. Because withdrawal is taking place at the end of each month. Plus 0 by 2. So average period will be 5.5 by 12. Write the formula. Once you write the formula, average period formula, here you have to write. Then other cases you can just substitute. So it is 5.5 by 12. And the amount is 3300. Show this calculation. Not in your rough calculation sheet. With your answer, you have to write. Then the third one, Raj. Yes, how he is withdrawing? He withdrew 40,000 at the end of each half year. How many half years are there in 1 year? There would be two. Half years means every 6 months. So you have to do 40,000 into 2, that's a total drawings, rate is 12%, and what will be the average period? What's the formula for average period? The months left after first withdrawal. How many months would be there after first withdrawal? Here he is withdrawing at the end of each half year. After 6 months, he is withdrawing. So how many months are there after first withdrawal? There would be 6 months. After last withdrawal, 0. By 2. So the period is 3 by 12 and the interest will be, the amount is 2400. Now we can post these figures. On which side will you write? On the credit side of P&L appropriation. Write in the inner column, Moli's current account, Bola's current account, and finally, who's the last one? Raj's current account. And write those amounts which we computed now. The amounts would be like 1800, 3300, 2400. Isn't it? Yes. Okay, you write in the outer column. It's written in the inner column in the textbook. No need to waste your time for writing the total. So you directly write in the outer column. Okay, so we wrote this. Then what is the next item given? We wrote salary. Okay, we have to allow a commission to whom? Bola was allowed a commission. So it must come on the debit side to commission. That is Bola's current account. Yes, how to calculate that commission? 10% of net profit as shown by P&L account. But what is the actual profit? 3,06,000 is given in the question. But is that the actual profit to be shown by P&L? No. Only because we forgot to take interest, we got 3,06,000. Actually, your profit is just 3 lakhs. So compute on 3 lakhs. What is the commission rate? It is 10%. So that is 30,000. Understood? Then, okay, now what we have to do is, it's over. Items are over, both on debit and credit. Now we have to find the balancing figure, and that will be distributed among all three partners. And that time you have to remember one thing, this is a question with guarantee of profit. So when you write the balances, when you divide it, leave one line and write. So it is profit here, the credit side is more. So to profit transfer to Molly's current account. Then Bola's current account, leave one line and write. Since I don't have space here, I'm writing like this. You leave one line and write always if it is a question with guarantee of profit. Then Raj's current account. Okay, so this is how you have to write it and find the balancing figure. The balancing figure, it is 150,000. The distribution of profit, 188,500 you will be getting, and 188,500 must be distributed between 3 in the given ratio, that is 3:3:4. Read the first sentence, the ratio is given there, 3:3:4. So just divide and take. Now Molly's amount will be 56,550, which you must write in the inner column, the divided amount. Then the next person again same 56,550, and the third one Raj 75,400. I'll just rub this. See, Raj is to be given a guaranteed profit of, what is the guaranteed profit figure? 150,000. It is given there in adjustment number 4. So Raj is to be given 150,000. That must come in the outer column. As per ratio, he is getting only 75,400. Whichever is higher, you have to pay. So 150 should come in the outer column. That means there is a deficiency, and that deficiency amounts to 74,600. 150 minus 75,400. This is the deficiency. Who will bear this? If nothing is mentioned, other two should bear. In the given ratio means, see the ratio between Molly and Bola, 3:3. That means they will share it equally. Not always equally, always you have to take in the old ratio. In the previous question also we did like that, 4:2:2. Here the old ratio is 3:3. That's why we are taking it equally. So this deficiency we will share it equally between the partners. So from Molly you have to less Raj's share of deficiency. Just divide it equally, 74,600. Into 1 by 2, the half, 37,300 we have to less. Here also we have to less 37,300. You must write less Raj's share of deficiency. If nothing is mentioned, both will give. Then that portion must be added with Raj's amount. Add deficiency recovered from, since it is the same amount, you write it together from Molly and Bola. You can write it together. What is the total amount? The deficiency is 74,600. Or else you write deficiency recovered from Molly, 37,300. Again, deficiency recovered from Bola, 37,300. Since it is the same amount, I wrote it together. If it is different amounts, you have to write separately. Yes. So we added the deficiency with Raj's amount. So now Raj will be given the guaranteed profit. Then you have to write the totals and then close your account. P&L appropriation is over, but we have to do one more account. It is asked in the question, partner's current account. And as usual, just like you prepare partner's capital account, you have to draw the format. Particulars, and here we have three partners. So you draw three columns, three amount columns, Molly, Bola and Raj. Yes, partner's capital account, how did we start? We started with the opening balance. Here we don't have any opening balance given. If you have, you write. It may come either on the debit side or on the credit side. current account can have either on debit or on credit. Whereas capital account, the opening balance will be always on the credit side. So here we don't have any opening balance, so you leave it. Now you look into your P&L appropriation. There you have written two interest on capital. Then in a column you have shown the division. Molly's current account, Bola's current account, Raj's current account. Just take all those items to the opposite side. So those current account figures will come to the opposite sides now. And you can write by interest on capital. Just copy those figures from your previous account 25, 40, 20. Then salary. Salary to be given only to one partner. Is it to Molly? Yes, 4000. By commission. So we are just copying it from the previous account. To the opposite sides you have to transfer. 30,000. That is to Bola. Then there is the profit figure also. That also transferred to current account. So that amounts we have to take by being taken from P&L appropriation. So you write by P&L appropriation, or if you want you write by profit also. That is again correct. By P&L appropriation, or you write by profit. Just take the differences. I mean, already you have written, no? What is written in the outer column? Those figures you have to take. 19,250. So we are just transferring to the opposite sides now. Again 19,250, then 1,50,000. Here you had to write in the, yes, here you had to write in the outer column 19,250, the balance figure. 1,50,000 already we have written. Then from the debit side you have to transfer two interest on drawings. Before that, we have to write one more item. On the debit side, you must have something like drawings. We don't have drawings in P&L appropriation account. We just wrote interest on drawings in appropriation. But in current account, see, drawings means he is withdrawing for his own personal use. And this will affect the partner's account. So, partner's current account or capital account, when you prepare, it must include this item, drawings. Whereas in P&L appropriation, you don't need. So drawings figure, it is given in the question, drawings figure 40, 20 and, 40, 60 and 80,000. It is given now, assuming that Bola withdrew 5,000 at the end of each month. So how we computed the drawings? 5,000 into 12. So we got 60. Then for Molly, it is 10,000 into 4 because it is at the end of each quarter. And for the other person, we did 40,000 into 2 because it is at the end of each half year. So that is how you are getting drawings figure. It is not directly given. You have to take like this 40, 60, 80. Just see your interest on drawings calculation. There we have drawings figure. Then we will transfer that interest on drawings also. So additional, what you have to take is only this thing. All others we are just taking to the opposite sides. From P&L appropriation. 1,800, 3,300 and 2,400. Now you have to just balance this account. So the balancing figure, two balance carry down. The balancing figure 6,450, 25,950. And the last one, it is 87,600. These are the balancing figures. Compute and write it. Now you can just close this. So this question, it's a comprehensive question. It includes all portions of this chapter. So do it. Understand it clearly. And you must practice it again and again. And this was asked in board exam also. That is important. Okay.